Hello everybody and welcome to Warhammer Online Return of Reckoning, the private server. Today we're going to be looking at the two factions, the six races, and the 24 classes available in this game for new players. So this game has two factions, the Realm of Order and the Realm of Destruction, more like Alliance and Horde and World of Warcraft. So its realm has three distinct races. The Realm of Destruction has the Dark Elves, Chaos, and Greenskins, while the Realm of Order consists of Dwarfs, the Empire, or Humans, and High Elves. Now, every race has four unique classes. That makes 24 unique characters in this game. Yes, you should write unique, because no class has an 100% mirror on the other side. So every class is unique with its own skill sets, gear, tactics, everything. They might look alike on the gameplay, but they are not 100% the same. So we're going to go in and see each one of them in detail. So we're going to start with the Greenskins. The Greenskins on the Realm of Destruction, they have four archetypes as every other race: a tank, a healer, a melee DPS, and a ranged DPS. The tank for the Greenskins is the Black Orc. The Black Orc can be played either with a sword and a shield or a two-handed weapon for a more DPS slash aggressive profile. Then we have the melee DPS, which is the Chopper. He can be played with an AoE spec or a single target spec. They're both good for six-man solo roaming and warband play. However, the more damage he does, the more damage he receives. So he's a little bit dependent on having a tank or a healer around, but still a good class to play. The range DPS for the Greenskins is the Squig Herder. It's an archer with a pet. It can be played for high damage, a little bit immobile build, run and shoot build, and Armor Squiggy. Armor Squig is the melee version, which is always fun. Then we have the Shaman. The Shaman is the healer for the Greenskins. However, he's a hybrid class, meaning that you can play him as a ranged spellcasting DPS if you wish to. Second race for the Realm of Destruction is Chaos. As we said, every race consists of the same four archetypes. So the Chosen is the tank for the Chaos race on the Realm of Destruction. He can also be played with a sword and a shield or a two-handed for a more aggressive profile. Convert him to a DPS. He has a different mechanic from the Black Orc. He uses auras that surround him and can deal damage along with other skills. The Marauder is the melee DPS for Chaos. He has a unique mechanic that he can change his arm through mutations, giving him a series of different abilities, quite useful in a lot of gameplay. The ranged spellcasting DPS for the Chaos is the Magus. He is a sort of a warlock, if you like, if you want to make a comparison. He summons immobile demons to assist him in combat for long range, short range, medium range. He can be played as a long range spell casting, if you like, sharpshooter, close range. He has some healing abilities from himself. It's a great high dealing damage DPS as any caster in any game. And the healer for Chaos, of course, is the Zealot. He's a good all-around healer. He could be played as a DPS, but healers don't really excel so much on DPS. Great healer, one of the best healers in the game. And finally, for the Realm of Destruction, we got the Dark Elves. The tank for the Dark Elves is the Blackguard. He can be also be played with a sword and a shield or a two-handed weapon. He has a bit of a different mechanic than the other two. That brings us back to being unique classes. Although on the same side, every tank and every race has their own little perks and mechanics that are specific to their race and class. This one uses Hatred. He can apply that to a friendly unit to use it to do more skills. So he has not just action points, but also Hatred that he can use into combat. The Witch Elf, this is the only character in the game that comes in a female version. You cannot do a male Witch Elf. It's your typical stealth roguelike character, high burst, stealth abilities, melee DPS for the front lines. The spellcat, their long range class is the sorceress, also only female, but high single target damage. You know what a mage, sorcerer, and sorceress can do. With a little bit of twist, that the higher your damage gets, those spells could fire back and damage you. You could actually die if you cast a lot of failed spells. And then the healer, the Disciple of Cain for the Dark Elves, is a frontline melee healer. He could also be played as a healer or as a melee DPS with some off-healing in the front lines. Another unique mechanism, you need to deal damage to build up your secondary pool of points to heal even better. On order, we have the Dwarves. The tank for the Dwarves is the Ironbreaker. He is similar to the Blackguard from the Dark Elves. He can also be played with a sword and a shield or with a two-hander. The melee DPS for the Dwarves is the Slayer, the equivalent of the Chopper on the other side. He can be played for single target AoE build. He excels on both, same as the Chopper. The long range DPS is the Engineer. He is the equivalent of the Magus from Chaos Race. Long range single target, bursty damage, AoE builds, utility builds for the whole party. And of course the Rune Priest, the healer for the Dwarves. Is the equivalent of Zealot from Chaos, all-around good healer. He could be played as a DPS as well, but this type of healers don't excel so much as DPS. Second race for the Realm of Order, we have the Empire. The tank for the Empire is the Knight of the Blazing Sun. As all tanks, he can also be played with a sword and shield or a two-hander for a more aggressive profile. He can be played as a DPS or a defensive two-hander as all the tanks. He uses the same mechanisms more or less as the Chosen with the auras. The melee class for the Empire is the Witch Hunter. He's the counterpart of the Witch Elf, your typical roguelike stealth unit, melee DPS. The long-range DPS would be the Bright Wizard, equivalent of the Sorceress on the Dark Elf. On the destruction side, with a little bit of a difference. Both are spellcasters, both are long range, but the Bright Wizard has a more specialized spells for the area of effect, while the Sorceress is a little bit more specialized on the single target. And finally, the healer for Empire is the Warrior Priest. The Warrior Priest is a frontline melee healer. He works pretty much the same way as the Disciple of Cain on the Dark Elves on Destro's side. And finally, we have the High Elves on the Realm of Order. Their tank is the Swordmaster. He can also be played as all the other tanks with a two-hander or with a sword and shield. However, the Swordmaster, as you can see, it's already shown to hold a two-hander. Every other tank, if you notice, they had a shield. He can be quite effective as a tank, just yielding a two-handed weapon. The melee DPS for the High Elves is the White Lion, another class with a pet, such as the Squig on the side of destruction. It's called the White Lion because they actually have their pet is a White Lion. Melee DPS, pounce and fetch abilities, very good character to play all around. The long range class, the range DPS for the High Elves is a Shadow Warrior. It is a bow class. It has a long range high DPS profile or spec, a run and shoot like the Squiggy, and he can also go melee spec, which is quite good and interesting. You can switch in combat your stances for long range, mobility or melee DPS. Finally, the Archmage is the healer for the High Elves. He's the equivalent of the Shaman, hybrid spellcasting healer. He can be played as a full heal or as a spellcasting long-range DPS. Great mobility. It works like the Shaman, more like a Warlock with the dots. Has a lot of dots to be applied. Now, although the Archmage is equivalent to the Shaman to the other side, or the Engineer to the Magus, or the Rune Priest to the Zealot, they're not 100% mirrors. I will say this again. So we have three different races on each side with four classes. That is 12 different classes on each side, 24 unique classes for this game. Now, all these classes have a maximum level of 40, and their renowned rank on PvP can reach 80. You can use a lot of those points to make your characters better, stronger, but we'll see that on later on in the next tutorials, how we use all those points. I hope that information about the classes is you find it useful. If you like it, click below a like, and you can also visit the website that we have for Warhammer Online Return of Reckoning and get some more information on the classes.